Hello, hello everyone. First of all, very happy Mahashivratri to all of you. I know, thanks for coming on this day. I'd like to open up by starting and asking you a question. How many of you are going to stay up all night today? No one? No one's young enough? There's one gentleman there, there's one madam there who are like enthusiastic. One madam over here, enthusiastic to stay up all night. So, okay, congratulations to all of you. So, I'm from this company called Practically. I don't know if you can see the logo there. Okay. Can you move on to the next slide? So, the reason I'm here today is to share my experience and to tell about some of our products that are coming up. Right. So I started, I did my schooling, basic schooling in Visakhapatnam. After my basic schooling, again, taught by some of the best teachers that I could ever imagine, I got into IIT Kharagpur. I studied electronics engineering at IIT for 4 years. And then I was more inquisitive. I wanted to see how the education across the world is. So I went to London School of Economics. I studied in London School of Economics, did managerial economics and strategy for a year. I worked in London, but then I also wanted to see how the education in US was. So I went to US, I did my MBA from Kellogg School of Management. I graduated in 2015, and in between, when I got bored of studying, I worked a little bit. So overall, I worked for about 10 years across the globe. Few years in London, few years in different parts of Europe, and 3 years in America, right? While I was working in US, I wanted to see how the education system was in India and how I could contribute to the education system. So I came back to India. And when I really toured about and understood how the education system was in India, what I understood was it was not different from what I had studied. In fact, it was much worse than what I had started. And there are a lot more students, there's much less infrastructure. And there are all sorts of problems, right? There are not enough teachers, not enough qualified teachers, and we are facing a lot of problems. So how do we solve some of these problems, right? That's the thought process behind, starting up something. And when I look back at my education, what I understood was, when I learned things by doing, when I learned practically, that's when we really understood and I could grasp concepts. So that was, the seed of starting something, and that's when we've started this company called Practically. We're using some of the new age technologies to really bring forward things that could be given through practical education. So I'll show you a quick demo, and then we could talk about what the product is and how we are working with schools and colleges and with students overall, right? Shubham, can you show a quick demo of AR?
To study about human skeletal system, the skull. The skull forms the endoskeleton of the head. It protects the brain and supports the structures of the face. The human skull consists of two sets of bones, 8 bones that constitute the cranium, also referred to as the neurocranium, and 14 facial bones that constitute the viscerocranium. Thus, the skull consists of 22 bones apart from the ear ossicles and the hyoid bone.
Really important when you learn concepts, right? You want to visualize. A student has to visualize concepts to understand them, to grasp them, and to be able to assimilate concepts into their life, right? So what we've done is we went back and saw what technology was available that could accomplish this in the best possible way. And what we are using is a three-dimensional technology called 3D models. All of these are based on 3D models. We are creating videos and experiences for the student, right? So we have, and at the same time, what we are doing is also we are covering the curriculum in depth. We are covering all syllabi in India and across the world. And we are doing 100% syllabus coverage between math and science. So this is a snapshot of a few videos that you are seeing, right? Yeah, and the next thing what we are doing is we are giving simulations, right? Simulations are basically what you're seeing on the screen. They're 3D models a student can play with. So visualizing, seeing is not just enough, but you want to do it with your hands to understand concepts, right? So that's what we are creating, and every student can actually play on their screens or at home or whatever device that they have available some of these models. So what you're seeing is a Rutherford experiment. Right. None of us could recreate this in our labs that we have with the equipment that we have. But how do you really give that experience to millions of students to actually do some of these experiments? And what we are doing is we are giving this experience digitally. So it involves each step, right? You can just place a foil, you can actually project electron beams, and you can place a magnet. You can see what really happens when you actually do this experiment. And what we are also using is an augmented reality technology, something that my team will come and show each one of you at the table on the device. You can project this on the table. You can project the model on the table. You can really on a virtually do the experiment digitally, right? That's what we are trying to give. So we are creating these learning packages, which is a video and a simulation and an augmented reality model, along with assessments. So that's broadly what we are trying to do and accomplish here in practically, right? And the way we want to work with schools and colleges is we want to kind of democratize the whole education process, right? We've just been hearing about quality of teachers and how you really need to pay a lot to kind of get a quality education these days, right? But why should that be? Why should everyone have to, you know, pay a lot to get quality education? Why can't really we be able to deliver that quality education to every kid in India, not just in urban India, but even in rural India, right? So that's something that is motivating us day in and day out to actually kind of get to the masses, right? So we are working with schools and colleges across India and across the globe as well to kind of penetrate deeper into the education system. With our technology, right, with the videos and stuff, most of the teachers can actually, like, it eliminates the differences between like a good and not so good teacher, and it also eliminates the difference between, you know, some student who can visualize content on his own versus somebody who cannot visualize content on his own. So any guesses on how much we charge schools and colleges on, you know, for this technology? So any guesses, any wild guesses from what you've seen?
Per month, per annum?
You can just, per annum, let's just say per annum.
$1,000 bucks, $2,000?
Per student? Per annum, per school?
No, not per student.
Okay. So, man, this is in 2019 India, 2020, we've like been in 2020. You're telling me the price that I paid for my IIT coaching center. Right? So jokes apart. So we are actually giving this product free of cost to all the schools across India. And thank you very much. And so the idea is, you know, we want really the schools to use this product and teach in the classrooms. So when I was in Kellogg School of Management, which is a top 5 business school in the world, what we had was, you know, teacher would give us a homework, a paper to read at in the house or in at home, and come back to class, and the class would be a discussion, right? Most of us would understand better because we are participating in the discussion, and the class participation would give us some marks in the examination, right? So that really helped us to think. It forced us to think over time, and that became like a natural way of learning. And we want all the schools to actually, like, teachers to give homework. Using our app, teachers can give homework to the kids. They can study at home if they have time. If they don't have time, we all know they'll come back to the class and learn, right? So that's what we are trying to accomplish, where we can eliminate the differences between a good student and not so good student, a good teacher and not so good teacher, right? And over time, we'll be able to create students who just not used to like rote learning or exam preparation, right? We'll create students who learn concepts. We'll create students who become better scientists, not just engineers, right? So that's the aim. We are basically, we work with most of the schools in India and across the globe. And if you are really interested in actually getting this product for your school, my team will be giving you the brochures with my visiting card stapled to it. You can actually come back to us, right? So that being said, Shubham, can you show some of the AR models? We'll also be showing you how the augmented reality models work. So I think if we really have a little bit money, we will also give you all the infrastructure and tablets free of cost to schools. But right now, we don't have as much money as a company. But I'm hoping, you know, in future, we'll be able to do that. The idea is if you have infrastructure on your school, we'll enable them free of cost. Absolutely, you'll get all the support from us. And if you do not have infrastructure, then we have partners who can help you get the infrastructure. Again, we don't charge anything out of the whole system. That's what. So this is exactly. So you've seeing this model on the screen. It's projected in this room. Who's the gentleman who's sitting? Can you? Who's the gentleman who's sitting beside? Can you wave to the model? Yeah. So yeah, that's what it's saying. So turn the model towards sir. Okay. So this is called augmented reality. What it does is it basically projects digital world onto a physical world, right? We don't have, like, for example, a child wants to learn about an IC engine. We cannot have an internal combustion engine everywhere, right? But you can have a digital internal combustion engine anywhere in the world, right? So that's where, see, this is an experiment that, titration experiment that, you know, we generally do in labs. But what I realized, even when I studied in school, for 10th class, I had one lab experiment. And I really couldn't understand anything in that lab because you're always scared. You don't know what beaker will you break in the class and how much will you have to pay. So at the end, what you do, you come back home, by heart all the values that you need to do, you need to get to, and go back and somehow produce those values in the examination. Right? That's what I did primarily. But this is what will really help students, right? In terms of they can do all of these experiments at home, come back. Even then, even one lab that you see is sufficient for you to learn, right? So this is an electron model that most of us really have to study, but you know, chemistry is always a little harder to study. Again, this is a biology model that we are showing you here in the room. It's a skull with the brain, and you can actually break the skull and see and all these elements in the classroom. So the idea is, you know, a teacher will be able to display some of these. She wants to teach an experiment, she can display the experiment in the classroom. A student can see, and they can go back and learn, right? So this is what we are creating. This is the only company, or we are the only company in the world with this sort of a content. And like someone said, right, quality doesn't come cheap, but we are giving it free, so it can't get cheaper than that, right? So again, this is a solar system. 9 planets in the solar system. Can you project the solar system again, please? Yeah, so you can really look at the sun, moon, earth. It's now easier to imagine, understand how the solar system is. You don't have to Google, or don't have to watch on YouTube for free videos. We give you videos as well. This is just one part of the equation. We have videos which explain this, so you don't have to really struggle to explain the concepts as well. So this is broadly, you know, the technology that we have. I would stop here and open up for any questions that you may have, right? And if you want to touch any of these models, experience, my team is standing there. Shubham, can you come outside? So they will be able to. You can use the tablet and experience any of these models if you'd like to. And that being said, any questions you may have, we'd love to answer.
What's the hardware required?
Yeah, sir. One question at a time. I have all the time in the world. I'm here. And okay. No, so we are not in the business of selling hardware, so you can use any hardware, right? So it's free for all of you here.
Is there a trial period for how long?
No, it's free. You use it for a year. If you don't like, tell us, and we'll try and change something that you'd make it like it.
Yeah. So see, what we are trying to do is, firstly, I think there are two parts to it, right? First, it's a goal, right? I want every student in India to be going global, right? I really want India to be on a global map, right? So we are working with schools to make that happen, really, right? So we want to keep it free, but at the same time, like I said, right, we are a company, we have to somehow sustain, and like I said, if I have money, I'll give you all the hardware as well. So what we are trying to do is, if the student wants to study at home, okay, it's no compulsion. If the student wants to go home, learn, then they have to buy the product, okay, at a very reasonable price, and we are still deciding the price, and the idea is, and for example, a parent, right, has two kids. One is in sixth class and the other is in eighth class, right? They can buy one product and they should be able to use it for their sixth class kid as well as eighth class kid, right? And the other thing is somehow, like, you know, we don't want to curtail students' learning as well. If suppose student, you're teaching in class like at seventh class syllabus, but how much can you teach in a class, right, in a year? You can only cover as much as the seventh class curriculum. But the student is really inquisitive. He wants to learn more. He's interested in, say, biology or physics, right? He can keep on studying, and the product, whatever, one license that they buy, they can study till whatever, how much ever content that they consume. So we do not curtail child's learning as well, right? So we are charging a minimal price for the student at home learning, not at school, right? And that is at will. We are not asking schools to force parents to buy. You don't have to force, right? All we are asking is, please use the technology. Please make students learn. That's what we are asking.
Do you give a kind of an app to the school, or do you give all this that the school can use, the way you just showed it now? Can a teacher use it in the classroom?
Yeah, so... Yeah, so we have a application for the teacher. For example, you know, you're teaching, say, a certain topic, right? You can actually mark all the assets, download the assets at home, go back to the class and use it. That's one way, right? Suppose a school says, hey, we have internet, but we don't want teachers to use internet in the classroom, right? So we work with each school to understand what their capabilities are, online, offline, and we try to deliver in the best possible way.